When the curtain came up on the 2009 NHRA season, Tony Schumacher may have been the five-time reigning Top Fuel champion, but something was different. The crew chief who'd been tuning his car for those five consecutive championship seasons, Alan Johnson, had left to start his own race team.
Their entire team left to a person. We had to assemble a new team. Like my wife had said, are you sure you want to do that? I mean, where can you go? Only down.
So the question was, what kind of chance did Schumacher and his U.S. Army team have of repeating for a sixth straight year?
There wasn't a question mark. The answer was no, he couldn't repeat. But to anybody, if they're honest with it, didn't give him a chance. Would Tony win some races? Sure. Would he get off to a good start? Probably, because they still got the Alan Johnson combination in there. They're going to be good in the beginning, but wait till they use all those parts up and, you know, wait till they got to start running all the stuff on their own. And nobody gave him a shot. I mean, nobody.
You know, there had been a lot of talk over the winter of, you know, how Tony's success is going to deteriorate because Alan Johnson had left. We had gone to three races and the media, you know, that's it. He's done.
But in the semifinals at Houston, the Army team got what it and what Top Fuel fans everywhere had been waiting for.
Tony Schumacher and Larry Dixon. It was going to happen sooner or later, and now it's happening. The O'Reilly Spring Nationals. Mike, is there any ego involved in this one?
We all knew it was coming. There was no doubt. Because that was my old team. He's a great driver. We knew it was going to be a battle. And you only get one shot at running the first time against each other. One chance. If you can't dig deep at that moment, probably shouldn't be driving one of these cars.
The track holds, and take a look with that hole shot. Tony Schumacher, 389 with a 5. The first grudge match is done, and Schumacher is the winner.
After dispatching the Johnson-Dixon team, Schumacher finished off the event with another thrilling hole shot win.
Well, and he hammers it down this time. Schumacher gives Mike Green the win over Corey McLenathan.
It let them know right there that, wow, we got a fast car, but geez, these guys could beat us. And it was an immediate step up in confidence for each one of my guys, for my crew chief. It was what they needed.
In the following race at Las Vegas, the Army team won again, and in the process took over the Top Fuel points lead five races into the season.
Right now they're saying, Alan, who?
Three races later at Bristol, Tennessee, the team that wasn't supposed to win captured its third event of the season and continued to build the case that it wasn't going to relinquish its crown without a fight.
Tony Schumacher, looking for and getting his third win of the season.
I don't think there was really a turning point, but after a while, you know, you get to the middle part of the season, you go, well, these guys are hanging in there.
In the midst of that fine run, Tony chalked up a record, not just for Top Fuel, but for all categories, when he registered his 35th consecutive first-round win at Topeka.
It's an amazing record, because first round is the most pressure. It doesn't really matter who's in the other lane. A part can break, you know, throttle cable, this, that, something stupid. You know, you're talking about a year and a half. A long time to get by that person.
Oh, big fire for Tony Schumacher. He takes the win.
By the time the teams came to Indianapolis for the U.S. Nationals, it was apparent that the naysayers who'd written Tony Schumacher off before the season began would have to reconsider their assessment.
Wow, there it is.
Track record elapsed time of 383 with a 6. 316 miles an hour in just 1,000 feet.
At Indy, Tony was hoping not only to win his fourth event of the year, but also to tie legendary driver Don Big Daddy Garlitz as the only driver to win the Big Go 8 different times.
Garlitz wins it. Don Garlitz, most all the way in the near lane, wins it.
And the race lived up to its billing as Tony Schumacher and Larry Dixon, the only Top Fuel drivers to win the U.S. Nationals in a decade, squared off in the final round. Amazingly, it was Tony's 10th consecutive final round appearance at Indy.
Big Daddy Don Garlitz was there. He's waiting to see if we do it, and not just waiting, pulling for us. They were running great. There's not one single fan that could ask for a refund of their money watching me and Larry Dixon in the finals at Indy.
Tony Schumacher, he runs even with that man.
He ties Big Daddy. How about that?
8 wins for Big, 8 for Tony Schumacher.
I was smiling from ear to ear. The second I pushed that pedal down, all the way to the finish. When that wind light came on, I'm surprised I didn't jump out of it at 300 miles an hour. It was that exciting.
Dixon and Schumacher left Indy second and third respectively in the countdown standings. In the top spot was Top Fuel newcomer Antron Brown, who had plenty of respect for his Schumacher Racing teammate.
Oh, what a race.
Oh, man, was that good! Antron wins it!
It feels good that he beat one of the best at the game. He's won more Top Fuel races than anybody in history. And if you could beat him in a final round or you beat him in a round, you have accomplished something serious because he's a great driver. But when you come up against that U.S. Army team and you know they have all those championships, you always throw a little extra flame in that tank because you definitely want to take the champs down.
And that great team would get the best of Antron Brown in Dallas and then take Larry Dixon and the Alan Abbey team one more time in the finals, giving Schumacher and company a 27-point lead with 4 races to go.
Wow! Schumacher!
We've done a lot of neat things together, and to be there, you know, when, you know, at the last minute, you know, when he's running behind in the points, you know, it's really amazing to watch, you know, him and the team, and, you know, just the intestinal fortitude, their warrior ethos that they've got to push it through to become, you know, winners at the very end.
As the teams made their way to Pomona for the 2009 NHRA season finale, Tony Schumacher and Larry Dixon were locked in a virtual dead heat at the top of the Top Fuel standings.
Dixon's the kind of guy that has been on my list forever. He's a great driver, always part of a great team. You never write him off because I've seen him do things in a car that are fantastic. He's a great rival, true rival.
Lining up for the final qualifying round, Dixon held a 2-point advantage. But Tony ran a 3.77, low ET of the weekend, in what was clearly the most important qualifying round of that weekend, or perhaps any weekend.
Do or die. You know, end of the world comes and there's no racing. I'm the champ. I'm 1 point in the lead. What we really were hoping for, like everybody, is that we raced in the finals. And the winner is the winner of everything, because that's cool. That's what I would rather have. That's what Larry would rather have. Throw it all out the door. Let's just battle.
But that epic battle would never get to happen, because in the semifinal round, while Tony Schumacher waited for his turn to run, Larry Dixon got beat.
Like I said.
There it is.
Wow. Massey puts down a 381, 316 miles an hour.
Tony Schumacher is your champion. How about that?
And I just sat there like, I didn't have to do anything. For the first time in my career, I didn't have to do anything. I mean, we had to win many rounds throughout the year to be in that position, but at that given moment, I didn't have to do the job. I just got to be the champ. Not quite as gratifying, yet 1,000 times more gratifying because we just beat them. We beat them.
With all the things that he had done in his past, you know, going back to the Indy legacy, to the run in 2006, to the great season he had, to come up in 2009 and win the championship with Mike Green, I think may have been the best single accomplishment for that team.
For me, I mean, winning a championship's been, you know, lifelong goal. So it just wasn't Alan tuning the car why Tony won all those championships. He had something to do with it, driving the car. And Don is a team owner and the U.S. Army is a sponsor.
Brand new team. Really the only two constant things there were Tony and my ownership of the team. And the third thing was the sponsorship by the U.S. Army. Mike Green and everybody on that team stepped up to the plate and did what was necessary to continue on with the championship run.
All in all, it was just about the perfect way to wrap up what can only be called a decade of dominance.
Tony has earned what he has as far as being a champion. He is the true champion when it comes to being on the track and off the track with the Army. They couldn't ask for a better guy.
If you never did anything in the rest of your career, the way I've lived, the way we've performed has been spectacular. And it has been, once again, a gift.